Hey guys, okay, so we are so glad that you're here. We have decided to start a YouTube channel just kind of to answer questions. We've been getting a lot of Facebook messages and emails just kind of asking us about the business and asking for pointers. So obviously we can't get to every single individual person, so we figured just doing a vlog maybe once a week or so to try to answer your questions. So Andy has been jotting down the questions that we have been being asked most, so we could kind of try to cover those today for our first vlog. And then he will continue to do that each week, just kind of jot down or print out the emails with the questions so we can hopefully answer most of your questions for you. Okay, so one of the main questions that we're being asked is, how did we grow the business? So, obviously, Andy, if you want to tell them about your retirement or whatever, because that was huge with growing the business.
I was in the golf industry for a long time, working 70, 80 hours a week. I never really paid much attention to Amber's business, to be completely honest with you. I woke up, I went to work, I got home at basically dark every day. So it got to the point where I was getting really stressed out, and she kept telling me, like, don't worry about it, don't worry about it, just we'll figure it out. So I started looking into the numbers, and I was like, what am I still working for? So we decided to make the move. I don't call it retiring, because technically I work for my wife now, so we just put our heads together and we figured out a way to make it work and continue to grow.
He doesn't work for me, he works with me. So yeah, I would say, so Andy retiring from the golf industry definitely was huge for us growing the business, because I was maxed out with what I could do, only being one person. The business was growing, and I just couldn't do any more. I was maxed out with time, so when he came on board 100% to start working, it definitely helped us, because he was able to bring so much more to the table than I was capable of doing, because I just didn't have the time to do it. So that helped, as well as I talked to a few like fellow boss babes, not necessarily in the boutique industry, but they do have like their own online business, so to speak, and I kept hearing over and over, especially in the boutique community itself, to never put your eggs, all of your eggs in one basket, which is exactly what I was doing at the time. And Andy really pushed this issue with me, because I don't like change. I never have. Even whenever we've moved into different homes or whatever, like, I always panic. I like things to stay exactly the same always. So he really started pushing for Instagram, because I was only focusing on Facebook. That was it. That's where I made my sales. I didn't want to try anything new ever. And he just kept pushing and kept pushing. So last November, we started working Instagram. I think we have 1,300 followers. I think it was November, but we really started like really at least posting a few things a day on Instagram, like really trying to work Instagram and pay attention to it and not just do Facebook over and over. And I think within like a few months, we just reached over 10,000 followers. So we're super stoked about that. But that has helped so much. It's a completely different forum, so to speak. So not only are you getting people from Facebook, but now you're also getting people from another forum. And I think that that drove so many sales. So many people that we weren't reaching from Facebook were now being reached through Instagram. And I think that helped so, so much. Also live videos. I was always so scared to do live videos. I didn't want to be in front of the camera. Now you have to get me to shut up when I'm in front of a camera, because I've been doing it for so long. I'm comfortable now, but I was reluctant. Like, I did not want to do Facebook Lives, and I'll never forget the first time we went live. Our sales that night were just huge. It was like we just knew it was time to retire him from the golf industry, because the sales that night, we knew we were onto something. And so I definitely would say, if you're looking into doing really any kind of home business, or especially like a business ran via social media, live videos are huge. People want to know your personality. You can post 1,000 pictures.